When 30-year-old Maren Vanderholm opens her eyes, this is what she sees. Dark blood images. She wasn't born this way. She had a cataract at birth and was diagnosed with glaucoma at the age of 4. Since then, her vision slowly deteriorated. Today, only 2-5% of it is left. Life has taught her to feel that she doesn't need preferential treatment. Maren is trained as a piano tuner, but getting a job has been difficult. She survives on unemployment benefits. Her world revolves around her two daughters, Lakhna and Nora. Having low vision doesn't make her any less of a mother. Her daughters adore her, even though her low vision compromises her ability to help them in their schoolwork. Get around, things most parents do.
Lana, the tall one, is a bubbly girl and she's into sports and music. She's also very creative. Nora, my little girl, is young, but she's a tough daredevil. She's like a boy in a princess dress. Well, my mom is a little blind. We have many people who accompany us. They bring my little sister to school. We are also doing something together with them because my mom isn't able to do everything. We have to be careful where we place things in the apartment, especially when we move something around. But it's not a problem that she's blind. You don't realize it that much.
Maren may be single. She has no family in Erfurt, but the German state that gives a monthly disability allowance for the blind cares for her. Susan Papp, a family care worker, has been helping the family for 3 years now. She affirms that Maren is a remarkable mother. Maren has to apply for the support annually and she says she gets nervous with the spontaneous child protective services. The first time we met her, preparing to meet the care workers.
If they don't accept my application for support, I would be left alone with everything. It would be tough. It would be a shock. It would be very radical for our family. From the point of organization, it would be very complicated for me to bring the kids to school and pick them up since I am alone.
We later learned that her application was successful. Gisembai Vehiga is a scenic mosaic of rock after rock. 30-year-old Maureen is the third born of 8 adult children. Her two brothers are blind. She lost her sight at 1 after bouts of severe migraines. Maureen says she learned how to sew at Kibosi School for the Blind. It was there that she met the father of her only daughter, Vanessa Ngaira. At 5, Vanessa is afraid of what she cannot see. Her mother says that after she was born, doctors told her that she had cancer of the eye, but she could not afford treatment. Nothing can be done for her visual pathway, and raising her is difficult for Maureen.
Bado tunawapenda, tunawashughulikia. Shida ni kwamba wazazi walipoaga dunia, imekuwa vigumu kuwalea kwa sababu wazazi walikuwa wanawashughulikia zaidi kuliko sisi. Lakini tunajikakamua kwa neema ya Bwana kuona ya kwamba wanaendesha maisha kama sisi wenyewe.
For their case, because of the changes, the anatomical changes that have occurred in their eyes, they are not able to regain their vision, but still there is hope because we have a vision therapist, we have a low vision department, which is a key department in our outpatient complex, and its role is to be able to help people by teaching them skills that will enable them to be able to move around. When somebody is not able to see very well, that has its own stresses. There's need to be able to counsel such patients so that they're better able to adjust to their life situation.
Back home, when it comes to blindness and eye care, the numbers and the statistics are quite daunting. Most of them are actually estimates, and it is hard to account for every blind person and person with low vision in the country. Well, most of the responsibility taken for such cases is done by missionary hospitals. But what if the state could take more responsibility, as is the case with Germany? Unlike Maren, Maureen cannot fully rely on the state, but on the kindness of her family and sometimes well wishes. Their paths may never cross, even though they both want the same thing, to raise their daughters. Dorcas Wangira, KTN News.